Yeah, so the long-term solution is to cement off this well. And when they say that, that's literally what they mean. They're going to fill it up with cement, and that'll block the oil from getting out. The way you do that is you have to have another way of getting the oil out below the depth at which you're going to cement it. And so they're out there right now with two new drilling platforms, drilling to try and intercept the well that already exists and is leaking into the Gulf, down at about 18,000 feet below the ocean surface. And that well down there is, you know, it's less than 3 feet in diameter, and they're trying to hit it at 18,000 feet depth. And the fact is, they can do that. You know, it gives you a sense of the amazing technology that's involved in these operations, the fact that they can do that. If all goes to plan, that'll happen in August. But, you know, you can hit that. Will you hit it in August? Well, I hope we hit it in August, but you know, it could take several months longer, and if there's hurricane season and they have to move the platforms out, that could set things back. It remains to be seen. I suspect that the end result of this is that BP will split into a couple different companies, and one of the majors in the U.S. or in the Netherlands, because Shell is a Netherlands company, will buy up part of it. And they'll do it not because they're destitute from paying things back, but as a way of getting out of paying things back. Is the industry really going to change? No. We need it too much. And we've grown addicted to it being cheap. So it's not going to change dramatically. The whole emphasis on, oh my gosh, when this oil hits the coast, that's going to be so terrible. The oil is out there. It's terrible. It doesn't have to hit a coast to be terrible. You know, we're polluting an ocean basin, killing off the fisheries and shellfish stock. When it comes up on shore and, you know, gets on birds and animals that we find cuter in some sense, it seems more real, but it's real every day. It's out there shutting down the fishery. And, you know, millions of southern coastal people make their living from that. And it's going to be years, if not longer, before that really gets back to its original, or to its, the state it was in last year. You can't have 100% success rate. You just can't. You know, one person asked me, you know, we can put people on the moon. Why can't we fix this? Well, on our way to the moon, there were failed missions and people died. And you just can't have 100% success rate. What you can hope to have, however, is an adequate and quick response to when something does go wrong. And that's really what we didn't have. And that's why we're seeing this now and well into month two.